Well, good morning. Welcome to worship this day as we gather together here at Grace Lutheran. Good to be together again. Can we all just get it out of our system? Skol Vikings, right? Are we not Vikings fans here in the room? Okay, all right. Well, we got that out then. So, just want to make a few announcements before we begin our worship time together here. Another baptism today. Ayla Lynn Croat is here with Alyssa and Dylan and the rest of her family, and so we're excited for you and to share in this blessing of the faith this Sunday as you bring Ayla to the font of holy baptism. So we celebrate again this week. So it's coming true. Last week I talked about having a baptism every Sunday, so we're on a roll here. So, but good to be together with you. Just a few other announcements. To make just a note that our mentor meeting will be held right here in the sanctuary right after our time of holy worship. The rest of you are invited downstairs to share in some fellowship and coffee together. Monday, we'll be hosting again the Cooking with Grace meal. They're serving scalloped potatoes with ham, vegetable Caesar salad, and blueberry cobbler for dessert. So grab a friend and join us in the fellowship hall downstairs tomorrow, beginning at 5:30 for that meal. Backpacks for Jack's. We pack about 59 meals for kids to take home over the weekends at Dawson Boyd Schools, and so we're looking for people to come and help us pack those lunches on Thursday, January 19th, and then Friday, January 29th at 1:30. Just meet right at the cafeteria. If you can help us out with that, you can give us a call at the church office and we can give you some more information. But Backpacks for Jack, so it's a great program that the Dawson Boyd Ministerial sponsors. Our congregational meeting is coming up February 12th, so please make note of that, and we'll have a shortened worship time, not a shortened sermon, but a shortened worship time. We'll begin our meeting at 9:45. That allows me enough time to get out to Providence to help them with their worship service. Want to remind to let you know, too, on February 5th at Our Saviors of Baxter, we'll be having a family benefit for the Duane and Charlotte Kruger family. That begins at 10:30, and they'll keep serving until 1:30. So if you get a chance to go out there and help the Krugers, I know that would be are really appreciated. So again, that's on February 5th at Our Saviors of Baxter, beginning at 10:30. It's always a delight to be able to share our worship with those in our community and, of course, on our radio. So today's services are given by Ken and Sandy Club in honor of their 5 grandchildren. So Peyton, Piper, Porter, Dice, and then Elizabeth and Logan Club. So thank you, Sandy, and thank you, Ken. Maybe listening to us. So thank you for sponsoring our worship service. And let's stand and we'll turn to the camera. And I think we're all set and we can wave to those that are joining us on our online worship service and then take a time to greet those that are around you today. Good morning. 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 Oh, there you go. Good morning. Morning. Were you guys on vacation? Oh, you guys were on vacation? Good. Good for you. Morning. Good morning. Good morning, Justine. Ryan, good morning. Morning. So we'll continue. Continue our worship with our brief order of confession and forgiveness. The words are printed for you in your bulletins. So we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. And then we pray, God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. And then let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Now, in the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare unto you the entire forgiveness of all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And then our opening hymn is Christ Be Our Light, hymn number 715 in the back section of our red hymnals.
Thank you.
And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And then let us pray our prayer of the day as it is printed for us in our bulletins. Holy God, our strength and our Redeemer, by your Spirit hold us forever, that through your grace we may worship you and faithfully serve you, follow you, and joyfully find you through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated for our baptismal hymn, Baptized in Water, hymn number 456. Let's invite the kids down now, or adults can come down and sit on the floor too if you'd like, but we'll have the kids come down because you get to represent our congregation whenever we have our baptismal font open and we have our newly baptized. So come on down, you can just sit right in front here and then you can get that's the best seat in the house, right down in front. So then Ayla's gathered here with her sponsors, Garrett and Morgan Anderson, and then Jared and Danielle Wager. So thank you for enriching Ayla's life by your support and your Olson, sorry. Olson. So bulletin says Anderson. Olson Anderson. Sorry about that, Olson. So thank you for enriching Ayla's life together. Well, let's begin with a word of baptism, some of you can follow along in our red hymnals. Our service of holy baptism is found on page 227. So in baptism, our gracious Heavenly Father frees us from sin and death by joining us to the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are born children of a fallen humanity, and by water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn children of God and made members of the church, the body of Christ. So living with Christ and in the communion of saints, we grow in faith, love, and obedience to the will of God. And so, Dylan and Alyssa, I'll ask you, called by the Holy Spirit and trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to have Ayla baptized into Christ this morning? If so, then say we do. And then as you bring Ayla to receive the gifts of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with her among God's faithful people, to bring Ayla to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, to teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, to place in her hands the Holy Scriptures and nurture her in faith and prayer so that Ayla may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others and the world God made, and to work for justice and peace. So do you promise to help Ayla grow in the Christian faith and life? If so, then say together, we do. And then sponsors, do you promise to nurture Ayla in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help her live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the whole Church of Christ? If so, then say together, we do. And then to the people of God gathered her, Ayla's family and the rest of our community of faith all ask you, do you promise to support Ayla and to pray for her in her new life in Christ? If so, then say together, we do. And then let us profess our faith in Christ Jesus, the faith in which we baptize as we reject sin and confess the faith of the church. So I'll ask you, do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? If so, say, we renounce them. Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? And then do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. And do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. And then do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And the Lord be with you. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God our thanks and praise. And then we bow our heads and hearts in prayer together. We do give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. And through the waters of the flood, you delivered Noah and his family, and through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. And at the river, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. And by the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death, and you raise us up to live in you. So pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that Ayla, who's now baptized and washed in these waters, may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Ayla Lynn, you are now baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ayla Lynn, you now belong to Christ in whom you've been baptized. Alleluia. And let the congregation declare alleluia this day. Alleluia. And then we bow our heads in prayer. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give your daughters and sons new birth, you cleanse them from sin, and you raise them to eternal life. Sustain Ayla with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord, and the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. And Ayla Lynn, child of God, you've been sealed with the Holy Spirit, and you've been marked with the cross of Christ forever. Amen. And then I'll take her just as she begins to fuss. All right, and then I'll bring her around so that you can make the sign of the cross on her forehead as well. And this is a sign of the baptismal blessing. Do you want to make the sign of the cross? Okay, there we go. Thank you. Okay, kids, here's Ayla Lynn, the newest member of the Church of Christ. Do you want to make the blessing on her forehead? Who would like to do that? Would you like to make the blessing? Okay. There you go. There we go. All right. And I'll bring her over to the family so grandmas and grandpas can bless her as well. And then we have some words of welcome for Ayla, and then also some words of support for Alyssa and Dylan as well. Not yet. So let's, we can turn to our bulletin and offer those. So our prayer is printed for us, or our baptismal promise is printed for us. Let's say that together. We promise to give Dylan and Alyssa our support, the child in the pathway of Christ. We offer ourselves as ones who take Ayla into our love, our prayers, and our daily lives, striving to build a community rich in the Spirit of God in which to nurture her. Okay. We'll continue to bring Ayla around as she's received into the love and care of the church, and we can receive her with our applause as well. And then our baptismal welcome. Should we say that together? Congregation, we welcome you into the Lord's family. We receive you, Ayla, as a fellow member of the body of Christ, child of the same Heavenly Father, and a worker with us in the kingdom of God. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And congratulations. Thank you, kids, for coming up and being part of Ayla's baptism. And we have some gifts over here for Ayla. Maybe could one of you go over there and grab that gift bag? And then we have a baptismal medallion to give to Ayla, and then a book. And we also have some certificates for the sponsors. And I didn't bring Ayla over here to introduce. Let's go over here, and maybe we can receive her with a blessing as well. All right. Did you want her? I don't know. She fits just perfect right here. And all right. All right. Yes, we got to light the baptismal candle. So the pastor seems to always forget that. All right. So Jesus says that he is the light of the world, and so we say these words to Ayla, to let your light so shine among others, so that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Amen. And she's just perfectly content, right? And so is the pastor. All right, congratulations again. We celebrate with you this day. And Alicia Beck is our lector this morning. Yeah, well, you guys can go back. Thank you, Alicia.
The first lesson is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 49. Listen to me, O coastlands. Pay attention, you peoples from far away. The Lord has called me before I was born. While I was in my mother's womb, he named me. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand, he hid me. He made me like a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me away. And he said to me, you are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified. But I said, I have labored in vain. I have spent my strength for nothing in vanity. Yet surely my cause is with the Lord, and my reward with my God. And now the Lord says, who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him, for I am honored in the sight of the Lord, and my God has become my strength. He says, it is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation shall reach to the end of the earth. Thus says the Lord, the Redeemer of Israel and his Holy One, to one deeply despised, abhorred by the nations, the slave of rulers. Kings shall see and stand up princes, and they shall prostrate themselves because of the Lord, who is faithful, the Holy One of Israel, who has chosen you. The word of the Lord. Today's psalm is Psalm 40, verses 1 through 11. I waited patiently for the Lord. He inclined to me and heard me cry. He drew me up from the desolate pit, out of the miry bog, and set my feet upon a rock, making my steps secure. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many will see and fear and put their trust in the Lord. Happy are those who make the Lord their trust, who do not turn to the proud, to those who go astray after false gods. You have multiplied, O Lord my God, your wondrous deeds and your thoughts toward us. None can compare with you. Were I to proclaim and tell of them, they would be more than can be counted. Sacrifice and offering you do not desire, but you have given me an open ear. Burnt offering and sin offering you have not required. Then I said, here I am. In the scroll of the book it is written of me. I delight to do your will, O my God. Your law is within my heart. I have told the glad news of deliverance in the great congregation. See, I have not restrained my lips as you know, O Lord. I have not hidden your saving help within my heart. I have spoken of your faithfulness and your salvation. I have not concealed your steadfast love and your faithfulness from the great congregation. Do not, O Lord, withhold your mercy from me. Let your steadfast love and your faithfulness keep me safe forever. The word of the Lord. Please stand for the gospel.
Holy Gospel this morning is a reading from St. John, the first chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Now the next day he saw Jesus coming toward him and declared, here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is he of whom I said, after me comes a man who ranks ahead of me because he was before me. I myself did not know him, but I came baptizing with water for this reason, that he might be revealed to Israel. And John testified, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and it remained on him. I myself did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water said to me, he on whom you see the Spirit descend and remain is the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit. And I myself have seen and have testified that this is the Son of God. And the next day, John again was standing with two of his disciples. And as he watched Jesus walk by, he exclaimed, look, here is the Lamb of God. And the two disciples heard him say this, and they followed Jesus. And when Jesus turned and saw them following, he said to them, what are you looking for? And they said to him, Rabbi, which means teacher, where are you staying? And he said to them, come and see. And they came and saw where he was staying, and they remained with him that day. It was about 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and one of the two who heard John speak and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He first found his brother Simon and said to him, we have found the Messiah, which is translated anointed. And he brought Simon to Jesus, who looked at him and said, you are Simon, son of John, and you are now to be called Cephas, which is translated Peter. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Well, I'm tempted sometimes when there is a baptism just to announce there will be no sermon this morning, which I know would be a tremendous disappointment for about two of you. And a welcome treat for all the rest of you. That'd be probably the first time that the whole congregation would break out in thunderous applause, right? Lifting their voices in song and praise to the Lord. If I were to say the baptism is the sermon this morning, you would probably be pretty excited about that. But I said, I'm only tempted to do that. I'm not actually going to do it. I'm just tempted to do it. And I'm tempted to do it because compared to the parents and the child who gather at the baptismal font, Alyssa and Dylan and the Olsons, sorry, we got your name wrong, and the Wagers, and the children who make their way up to witness that great event, all the people standing there, compared to the water being poured, compared to the prayer, remembering God's mighty acts and the words, Ayla, you are baptized now in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Compared to this, what are the words of a sermon? Not much. What are my words? Not much. Compared to the cross of Christ traced on the forehead, compared to the candle given, which we finally did, what are my words from the pulpit? Compared to the words, let your light so shine among others. Compared to all of these things, the words of my sermon often seem pretty weak, because baptism is such a wonderful, glorious thing. Something is happening. We can see it, and we can hear it, and we can touch it. Underneath the things we see, something more is happening, that God is with us. God is with us all the things that God promises in baptism. Safe passage, as if we are ourselves on Noah's ark. A new birth, adoption into God's family, resurrection, eternal life, grace and forgiveness, love that is stronger than death, a place prepared with many mansions. God promises that we will be clothed with God's righteousness, and that we will be part of God's new creation, and that we will be grafted into the living vine, which is Jesus Christ himself. All of these things are happening in baptism. When we see the water poured, and when we feel the cross on our heads, when we hear the words, we catch a glimpse of all of these wonderful and glorious things. So sometimes when I have a baptism, I'm tempted to say there will be no sermon this morning. The baptism is the sermon. But as you know, I never do. I never say that. Maybe what I should say is this: here's what baptism means. God is with us. And then maybe we could all say it as a congregation: God is with us. God is with us. And this baptism means that God will never let us go. Not ever. That's how good baptism is. And that's how good God's promises are for us. But that's not all. God is with us. And then God gives us a mission. God gives us something to do, right? Let your light so shine among others, so that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. God gives us a light to shine. God gives us work to do. And sometimes that work and that mission will get us into trouble. Sharing the love of Jesus is not for the faint of heart. It's true. Jesus is trouble. Jesus, yes, is also Emmanuel, God with us, but Jesus is also trouble. And he will save us from our sins, but he will also get us into trouble for his sake. There is going to be trouble, but God is in that trouble because God is with us. And maybe that's what we should say before a baptism. And that, I think, is reflected in Jesus' invitation to the two disciples this morning from our gospel text. This compelling call that Jesus offers to come and see, Come and see, Jesus tells them, and he offers no explanations for these two words, come and see. There's no justifications. He doesn't talk about who Jesus is as to why we should come and see. He just says, come and see. Later on, those disciples will be following him, and they will see, and they will hear, and they will experience things because they have followed him. But right now, all Jesus says to them is, come and see. And they come. And eventually, little by little, they begin to see. So come. Come to baptism. And then as we learn to follow, as we learn to behave like a Christian, as we learn more and more what the Christian life is all about, mercy and forgiveness, service and love, and finally, as you are learning and sharing and belonging, you discover that you believe, that you have come to see Jesus in your life, and that you've come to see Christ's love guiding you, that you've come to see his forgiveness setting you free. Here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin, your sin and the sin of the world. First you come, and then you follow, and then you learn to see and believe in who he is for you. The Lamb of God, the Messiah, the friend of sinners, the Son of God. And I think this begs the question, doesn't it, that what have we felt in our hearts? What have you felt in your heart? And what have you come to believe in your mind because of what you have seen in this Jesus? We have to ask ourselves that question. What have we seen in the witness of who Jesus is and how he loves, and how that makes a difference in the way we live our very lives? Truly, if Jesus is the one who speaks the word to us saying, come and see, then our relationship with him is not a bystander event. We're not on the sidelines in the game of life. We're not bystanders, we're in the game. So it's an invitation that elicits an action in us, a response from us. And I think the truth here is that Jesus extends this big invitation to us to come and see. And when we do come and see, then it is imperative that we go and we tell. And that's how kind of we end every worship service, right? We say, go in peace, serve the Lord, thanks be to God. So we come and see to go and tell. Come and see means that we have received an invitation to imagine that all of us are called to give witness to how God is present, to how Jesus reveals God, to give witness to how the kingdom of God is here and now and actually makes a difference in our here and now. So the invitation doesn't stop with Jesus' invitation with us. We go and we tell. It continues as we also invite others to come and see for themselves. We invite people to come and see Jesus in our lives. We testify how following this Jesus has changed us, why we follow him, and how Jesus has opened our lives and offered us his grace and his love ever so freely. Most of us don't have a miracle to point to, a special sign in this following. We just have ordinary things like we see here. Like water when we baptize, or the sign, small things like bread and wine that we share with one another when we gather at this table and at this altar, like people who forgive each other, however imperfectly. And yet still we are called to say, come and see. Come and see. Come and see Jesus in my life. Come and see Jesus when I am courageous. Come and see Jesus when I am weak. Come and see Jesus when I'm successful. Come and see Jesus when I fail in things. Come and see Jesus as we serve the grieving and the wounded. Come and see Jesus as we lead children and as we hold their hands. Come and see Jesus as we fall and as we pick each other up. Come and see Jesus as we listen and as we speak. Come and see again and again and again and again. Come and see. There are signs of hope even now all around us. Come and see that which heals the world and brings community together. Come and see God's vision for our common life. Come and see the constant and the disarming love of God that propels all of us, that propels our work and propels our love, that propels our commitments and propels our very lives. So come and see. Come and see. And then we bow our hearts and our heads together for the prayers of the church. Let us pray. We thank you, God, for all the people who have shared the hope that is with them, shared that hope with us. We thank you for those who first invited us to come and see and told us about Jesus and the healing that comes through him. We thank you for those who shared his love with us and who showed us the way to a fuller and a richer life he offers to all people. We thank you for those who told us that he is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world, the one who brings new life to all who turn to him. O Lamb of God, I ask your blessing to be upon all those who have witnessed to us, and for you to encourage and bring peace and joy to all those who this day share their faith with others. Lord, in your mercy, and Lamb of God, enable us to cooperate with your ministry that is so great in the lives of the people around us. Grant that we may be your ears and your eyes and your hands with friends whom we often take for granted, with enemies whom we have ignored or disdained, with our work colleagues of whom we have ignored, with the workers we forget to thank in shops or in garages or banks, with our neighbors whom often we forget. So Lord, in your mercy, and Lamb of God who gave yourself for us, grant the prayers of those who are near us in church today, and help me to be a good neighbor to them, to be a brother, to be a sister, to be a friend in your name. Lord, in your mercy. And Lamb of God, we lift up those in our community that the blessing of your healing and your peace and your joy may be upon them, those who are sick, those who grieve, those who are struggling with unhappiness or fear about tomorrow. Especially we lift up those in our community, Rick Oden, Brad Mattson, Tom Beals, Ken Klubb, Greg Tokolke, Roger Strum, Jim Anderson, Deb Lewis, Jack Flayton, Monica Kennedy, Julie Muron, Lauren Thone, Mike Thompson, Joey Anderson Ernest, Gary and Stephanie Childs, Amber Kruger, John Perry Peterson, Deborah Nalo, Ryan Engebretson, Arliss Buer, Doug Breberg, and Deb Trapp, and the family of Leroy Olson. We pray for people, all people who suffer in all kinds of ways, fighting cancer, awaiting a test result, enduring a lengthy illness. We pray for people who are struggling against poverty or against the cold. We pray for people who are uncertain about their marriage, or fearful for a child who is struggling, or for a parent whose health is declining. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lamb of God, you share the pain and you bear the shame of the world, and you bring to all who follow you healing and salvation. So continue to have mercy on us all and grant us your peace. In your strong name we pray. Amen. And now we receive our morning's offerings. And then we pray. O God of justice and love, we give thanks to you that you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need. Awaken us to the needs of others. And at the end, bring all the world to your feast through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.